Welcome back, Lancers. Today we are back again in our C tutorial series, and today's video's topic is pattern printing. This is part 2 of the pattern printing programs. So without further ado, let's get right into the video. So here, this is our first program in pattern printing of today's video. So now let's see what could be the concept behind this pattern. You see, there are 5 columns here. Column 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And there are also 5 rows. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So let's say I represent these values as 1, I. So this one is I1, I2, I3, I4, and I5. And here, let's say it is J is going like this. This one is J, and down one is I. So now you see J, when I is equals to 1, we are printing the star 1 time. When I is equals to 2, we are printing the star 2 times. And same repetition occurs in every single line. You see, when the I value is 5, we are printing star for 5 times. So this is the basic logic behind this program. So we can say that I and J are somehow interrelated to each other in this type of programs. So how can we understand that? Let's see in our programming session. So here we are back to our VS Code. First of all, let us include standard.h and the int main function. These two are the starting and the ending point of our program. So first of all, now what is our question? Our question is a star problem. You can see it over here. For that, first of all, we have to declare two variable I and J. This one is common, and also we have to make two nested loop of I and J. Now the question is, from where I should start? We have already discussed that I should start from I1 and it should end till 5. It's something like this, and it is increasing. Okay, sorry. It is increasing, that's why this one I++. Now inside that we have to write this J for loop. For that, now what is J is starting from 1 or 1, but the logic behind that this question is J is ending with I. That is why it both are interrelated to each other, I and J, and J is increasing too. Now we will just here write printf star. We will print stars here, and after each iteration or the execution of J loop, we will print a backslash n, which will ensure next line command. And here now the program is end. Now let's run this program and see the output. You see, we have got the output perfectly fine. So now let's move to the next question. This is our second bit program. So in our second program, also basic logic is I is interrelated to each other. I and J are interrelated to each other. Also, you can see when I value is 1, we are printing 1. When I value is 2, we are printing 2. When I value is 3, we are printing 3. So the basic idea behind this pattern is I will be looping from 1 to 5. In each iteration, J will be looping until I. For example, when I is 1, J will be looping 1 times. When I is 5, J will be looping 5 times. And in the middle of this process, inside J loop, we will be printing I value. This is what this pattern is all about. Let's see how to program this. Our next pattern is very similar to the previous pattern, just we have to print different values other than stars. So again, we will include standard io.h int main. And all this, yeah, and we will declare two variables I and j, and then we will make a nested for loop which will start from I is equals to, and now I is starting from 1, it is ending till 5, and it is increasing with each iteration. Now in the j loop, it is also starting from 1, but the logic is it should end before or when it is equals to I. So j plus plus. Now what we have to print here, we have already discussed that we have to print I value. So ampersand d, because I value is a number type or integer type, and here I, and then here, and we have to also make sure that after each line it should make a new line, or the pointer should goes to the next line. So for that we will use backslash in here. We will run the program. Now you see we have got the output perfectly fine. Now okay, some of you have a doubt that if we don't write this statement, what will happen? Let's see this here. I've made this a comment, and then we run it. You see all the numbers are in the same line. Why the pattern is producing something like this? Because it is not unable to change line after each iteration of j. First j iteration will print only 1, and after that it is not going to next line. That is why 2 is printed in the same line, and same goes for 3, and same goes for 4, and so on. So that's why we have to make sure that a printf backslash n, that is new line command, should be printed or should be executed after each execution of j loop. Now let's move to the pattern number 8. So now we are here with the third program. In the third program, it is the reverse pattern printing, or you can say reverse pyramid. So how to solve these kind of problems? Let's say, for example, let's say our I value is incrementing like this. In the first line, it is 1. In the second line, it is 2. In the third line, it is 3, 4, and 5. Here we have indexed each lines as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I is going from up to down. And now we have to index the j value. We know j should be something like this. So what could be the j? Let's say j will be here 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So now understand this logic. J will be start from 5 and it end till I. This is the basic logic behind this program. Now let us see what I am saying. For example, here I value is 2. When I value is 2, J will be looping until 2, that is 5, 4, 3, and 2. And during the execution of j, we are printing star. We will understand it again. When I is 3, we are the j loop is repeating 3 times. So basically inside for loop of I will start from 1 to 5, and for loop for j will start from 5 to I. This is the logic behind this pattern, and inside this j loop we will be printing star. Now let's implement this in our VS code. So our next pattern is a reverse pyramid. For that, we have to first include standard io.h and then int main. Also, now we have to declare inj. Now we have to make a nested for loop. Here I will start from 1, it will end till 5, so it is increasing with each iteration. And after this, again a for loop, j is equals to 5. This time j must be greater than equals to I. This is the basic logic behind this pattern. Now you see, and j is decreasing with each iteration, it should be j minus minus in place of j plus plus, and then we have to print star. So this is the program. Now we don't have to forget this backslash n, otherwise each star will, after execution of j loop, each star will print in the same line, and the line would not be changed after each execution of j loop. Now let's run this program. You see our pattern is produced here. Now let's move to the next question. This is our fourth problem. You can see in the fourth problem also, the base concept is same as the previous one. Just in place of printing star, we will be printing the value of I. Let's see what I'm saying. Here, I value is 1, I value is 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, for loop for I will be from 1 to 5. Here j will be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. In this line it will be 5, 4, 3, 2. In this line it will be 5, 4, 3. So basically it is ending with I. So in j loop it will be something like this. For it will start from 5, but it will decrement until it becomes I. So this is the basic logic. And now what we have to print in each iteration of j, we have to print the value of I. You see, when I is 1, we are printing I 5 times. When I is 2, we are printing 2, 3, 4 times. When I is 3, we are printing 3 times, and this goes on. So basically this is the logic behind this pattern. Now let's implement this in VS Code. Our next question is very similar to the previous one. For that we will just copy this program and paste here. Okay, now you see the only difference is that in place of printing star, we just have to print I value. So here we are printing I, and basically every logic is same in these two programs. Now let's run this one. You see we have printed the same pattern as in the question asked. So now let's move to the next question, or the last question of today's video. Okay, now here comes a character type pattern printing. This will be our fifth problem of today's video. Now let us understand what is the basic concept behind this character type pattern printing. Let us index these E, D, C, B, A as 0. Let us say I value here. I will go from down in the downward direction, and J here. J will go in this direction. So I will start the I loop from 0, 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Again, in the j value, we will start it from 4, but it will end in I, that is 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0 in first case because I is 0. In second case it will be 4, 3, 2, 1 because I is 1. That is why it is ending in 1 index of j. And now what we have to print inside that? So basically we have formed the for loop for each for of I loop will start from 0 to 4. For loop of j will start from 4 and will end till I. Okay, now but what we have to print inside, because we have to print a character type, you know, so for that we will use the ASCII numbers. So now what is an ASCII number? Basically ASCII number is a predefined table of numbers in which each alphabet, symbols, numbers are given a specific number. ASCII numbers are used in keyboards. When you press A, basically A is converted to ASCII number and that ASCII number goes to the processor. So we will use here. I will provide the ASCII table here. You can see. And now you see here that A value, A is 6, A is 65. The value A is 65 in ASCII table. So when we calculate that, we will print J plus 65. Now what will this do? Let us understand that in programming session. So this is a character type question, and for that we need to have a knowledge about ASCII code. So basically what is ASCII code, I will introduce you after this pattern printing. For now you just understand that ASCII code are the numbers which are assigned to each alphabets or a symbol in computer system. So let us first include standard io.h int main. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to first declare I and j, and then we have to make two for loops or nested for loops for I and j. I will be start from 0, it must be less than or equals to 4, and I plus plus. Now for j, it must start from 4, j should be greater than equals to I, and j should be minus minus. Why minus minus? Because it is decreasing with each iteration. Now what we have to print here, this one is a bit complicated. Why? Because we have to print a character type, so we are giving percentage c. Now which character we have to print? J plus 65. So what is happening here? Let's first make this backslash n, and let's just run this program and check if it is running or not. It is running fine. We have got the output perfectly fine now. So what is basically happening here? In the ASCII code, you can see here that 65 belongs to A value. Now let's say A, capital A is equals to 65. Let's comment this one first. Yeah, capital A is equals to 65. It is a fixed constant value which is followed by every single country. This is a standard programming language. So we are using standard ASCII codes. So now A is equals to 65, it is given. So what we have to print here? You see in the first line, you have to print from E, D, C, B and A. So basically what we are doing, we have to print E. What should be the value of E? Or you can say in E is, E should be something J plus 65 here. So what is 65? 65 is the value of A. And what is J? J is the value of this 4. So J is starting from 4. And here we are adding it to J. That means E is equals to 69 here. Okay. You can check it in the ASCII code programs. Now let's move to the ASCII code. So here we are back with the ASCII code table on our screen. So basically this is the ASCII code. Now imagine when you are typing. Let's say you are typing space bar. When you are giving a space or hitting the space bar key, you see here space bar character has decimal number or the ASCII number as 32. So the code 32 goes to the processor and processor understand that 32 means spacebar. That means the user is inputting spacebar. Similarly, let's say you are typing a name. Let's say something like ABC. So while we are typing ABC, but the keyboard is sending not ABC, but 65, 66 and 67. These ASCII codes are understood or identified by the processor as A, B and C values, and they know that the user is giving input as A, B and C. So this is what ASCII code is. You can see that these are the in the decimal here where it is written decimal. These are all the ASCII values. And also in the character type, a character, it is written the value, whose value is that those ASCII codes. You can see A starts from, capital A starts from 65 and capital Z end it at 90. Also, you can see that here, small a starts from here and it ends still here. Also, in the program, we have discussed that A is equals to E is equals to A plus 6, E is equals to J plus 65, where 65 means A and J is the value of J there was 4. You can see here E is equals to 69, same as we have understand in the programs. So now let's wrap up this video with these ASCII codes. Now you have to just make sure that you understand this ASCII code. You don't have to remember the complete ASCII code table here. Just remember that capital A starts from 65 and end capital Z end at 1990. And same you have to remember the small a to small z. These are the most important of them all. Now let's wrap this video. Thank you for watching.